Guys, look at this. Look at this. Look what they're making me do. Ah! Oh my, I don't even. Whatever. Sure. Let's max this out and turn this down some. No. It'll probably look different next time. Do you see what they're making me do? Do you see this? This? The... My friend and I, we will exchange words, and these words will be much sterner than they were for Grey's Anatomy. Much sterner. Okay, let's get this freak show on the road. Welcome to Wisteria Lane. Time to create your character and your family. Customize yourself with the upper left button. Select your husband and son. Oh boy. Where's Trailer Park Trash? There we go. And... okay, clothing rack. Oh boy, I get to pick clothing. That looks atrocious. That looks just awful. Okay. Oh, a jogging suit? Nah. There we go. Now we're styling. And by styling... No. I don't care. Random. Okay, that's who we wind up with. Oh, that's who we wind up with. Wait, let's get someone. Yes. My guy's got a black kid. And his name is Gilberto. What? I wasn't cheating on you. This is ridiculous. Wait a minute, I want to see something here. Yes, we are already... Okay, that looks creepy. Sure. What? I don't know. This is gonna be the most moronic thing ever. Start the timer. If I don't go insane first.
Young.
Good for you.
When I recall my time on Wisteria Lane, I think mostly of good things. Well-maintained lawns, and even better-maintained housewives. Of course, there is another side to life on this idyllic street. A darker side. One that my friends and neighbors would do anything to cover up. While we all wish to be the person our neighbors envision us to be, there are always secrets we don't want our neighbors to know. Some are secrets in name only, out in the open for all the world to see, while others find that no matter how much they try to conceal the truth, somehow things always find a way to come back to the surface.
Oh no, I have a scar! Dreadful!
As the most successful real estate broker in town, Edie Britt has always understood the importance of first impressions. A bad first impression can cause a prospective buyer to question their decision, while a strong impression will allow you to beat prospective buyers to the punch.
However, dog, first impressions quiet. Can often be misleading. Great. She's running around.
When Edie first met her new neighbors, she thought she had met the perfect family. But as Edie and everyone else in the neighborhood will soon find out, there's no such thing as the perfect family.
Murderous! What is this, the frickin' Sims?
Now that you've created your family, the first thing you should try is moving. Using your mouse, click the floor beneath the flashing arrow to move.
Oh my gosh.
Now let's talk a bit about moving the camera. If you ever have a problem figuring out where you are or where you want to go, you can always move the camera to get a better view.
Oh my gosh.
With that, you are now free to explore your house in Wisteria Lane. As you do so, look for green question mark signs around the neighborhood. Clicking on these will give you helpful tips about the object or nearby area. Have fun!
Vicious legs, unable to move away. The dying beast lets
you just received your first alert. Whenever you receive a goal or hint, the checkbox icon will appear to tell you that new information has been added.
Okay. Dog, if you don't shut up, there's gonna be heck to pay.
In the upper left corner of the screen is the current time
quiet.
Of
quiet.
Hello, I'm Edie. You are now involved in a conversation. To progress through a conversation, hover over one of the icons in the center of the screen to see what your dialogue options are, and then click on the line that you
want
to see.
What do you want?
But choose carefully. What you say will have an impact on the flow of the conversation.
Okay, let's just... I'm not sure. We'll be neutral.
I'm here to show you around your new house, silly.
Sometimes people have a lot to say. In those instances, a continue button will appear in the middle.
Do you
whatever.
Mind if I come in?
Apparently I have no choice in the matter. Traditionally, one is supposed to wait for a response to that question.
Thanks. Now let me give you a little dirt on this place.
What?
This house was actually built on an ancient Indian burial ground.
You can't be serious.
Jesus, I'm kidding. But you should have seen the look on your face just then. Priceless. There have been a few newsworthy events on this street, however.
What do you mean by newsworthy?
Moving on. This is some nice furniture you have in here. Wow, nice big TV.
This would be some kind of joke.
Actually, I just remembered that I have an appointment I need to get to. Houses don't sell themselves, you know. Billy, anyway, if you need anything, call me on my cell. Here's the number.
At the end of a conversation, an exit button will appear in the lower center of the screen instead of standard dialogue options. Click exit to leave the conversation.
Interesting. Get out. Shut the door!
If someone knocks on your door, click on the door.
No, go away. Fine, just open the friggin' door. Stop knocking! Stop knocking!
Hello, I'm Bree Vandekamp.
How can I help you?
I was just having coffee with some of the other women of Wisteria Lane, and I was wondering if you'd like to join us.
Sure.
Just go across the street and to the left. It's the big blue house with brick on the bottom and the immaculate garden. You can't miss it.
Okay.
Excellent. See you soon.
Right. Whatever. Hey, a computer. What the? Computer. I want to look at the computer. No. Oh, I don't want to... I can't do anything with the computer. Fine. Stereo. Sure, that'll work. Let's upgrade the couch. That's an expensive friggin' couch. Never mind. Go away. Okay, let's just go outside. Go.
If you're ever unsure of where to go, follow the blue compass arrow at your feet and it will guide you to where you need to go next.
Garden. Tend garden.
You should check your mail every day.
Okie dokie, let's check the friggin' mail then.
You've just acquired an object. To look at it, click on the flashing inventory button, represented by a purse, in the lower left. Your inventory button, indicated by
letter.
A purse, is where everything
an
you pick
unmarked
up will be
pill bottle?
If an item can be used immediately, a use button will appear beneath it in your inventory. Simply click on that button to use the item. The map button shows you where.
Okay. Whatever. I need to go to the blue house. I'm guessing that's it? Is this jaywalk? Doesn't matter. Turn the speed up. This is atrocious. Keep knocking. They do it to me.
Hi, glad you could make it. And look at you, all dolled up for a girl's night out.
A lot more work to do at home.
I'm sorry to hear that. Why don't you make yourself at home and take a moment to meet everyone personally?
What do you say we get right to the gossip? Sure. Let's not be gossips. That's kind of rude. I will cut in on this conversation, though.
Hello. So nice to meet you. I'm Susan Mayer.
Nice to meet you, too. Mrs. Mayer? Hi.
Oh, I'm not married anymore. Just call me Susan.
Wow, we are nosy as heck. What happened?
No, it's okay. Just the standard happy marriage turned bitter divorce. At least I got something good out of it. My daughter, Julie. One day, I found out that my ex, Carl, was cheating on me with a secretary. So
I guess.
I did the only sensible thing. I kicked him out.
Plum face.
Or he left. Depends on who tells the story, I guess. Well, I'm completely over him now. I can concentrate more on my children's books this way, too. So, tell me about yourself. What does your husband do?
Private practice down at the health center. Health center is a great doctor.
Really? I dated a doctor not that long ago. Dr. Ron. Didn't really end that. See, the thing is, I had just remarried my ex-husband for health insurance purposes, and I tried to protect Dr. Ron's feelings by not telling him.
What the? What?
But for some reason, he didn't get that I was just looking out for him.
I really feel like it's my place to comment.
I'm sorry, it's my fault. Here I am just meeting you, and already I'm expecting you to solve my problems. You just seemed really nice, and I had better let you get around to the other.
Bye. Creepy.
How is the family? Of course.
I could play the piano. Sure, let's play the piano.
You have to keep up appearances.
Are we talented? Hey, we know what we're doing. Sweet. That's enough. Just making sure I know what to do. Okay, let's go talk to these losers. This is ridiculous. This whole game is friggin' ridiculous.
Hello, I'm Gabrielle Solis, but you can call me Gabby.
Do I have to? I like your dress, I guess?
This whole thing, it's nothing special. Stella gave it to me years ago.
What
around
the?
Here, it's practically haute couture. Well, I don't want to be immodest, but I was actually an incredibly successful fashion model before I married Carlos and moved to Fairview.
Sure.
So, what does your husband do?
Worked at the health center.
A doctor. I guess we know that you're well taken care of. We should go shopping sometime. I know all the best places around here. It's been a real pleasure talking to you.
Bye. Go away. You are creepy and I don't like you.
Howdy, neighbor. Welcome to the neighborhood. I'm Lynette Scavo.
There you go.
Let me do a little preemptive strike here and apologize in advance for anything my brood might do to you or your house. They are amazing kids, but you know how it is? Sometimes they just get a little out of hand, especially when the three boys get together.
Should have locked my doors.
I find it's better to prepare the uninitiated for the worst. My twins sometimes act like they just escaped from a zoo, and my oldest just follows along on their adventures.
Boys will be boys.
When you work in advertising, you find all sorts of creative ways to deal with bad behavior. Tom and I found ways to handle them without resorting to spanking.
Okay.
Oh, yes. We traded staying home with the kids for the first couple of years, but now we found a way for both of us to work and spend time with the kids.
Work can be rewarding, I guess.
Excuse me? I was a stay-at-home mother for 5 years. I'm a great mother, and I couldn't love my kids any more than I do.
I did that one.
Hey, I understand. Anyway, I don't want to keep you all to myself.
Okay.
Now that we've gotten all the formal introductions out of the way, why don't you tell us a little more about yourself?
My family and I just moved to the town. We're getting ourselves acclimated to this.
Oh, how nice. And how long have you and your husband been together?
20 years or so, I think.
Hello? You're a woman. Shouldn't that number be etched in your mind somewhere?
My memory isn't in the best condition. I can
That's
sympathize.
A very strange thing to say.
I'll say. Just what do you mean by that?
That one. Sure. Memory loss.
I certainly wasn't expecting you to tell us that. I'm terribly sorry I asked. Perhaps we should move on.
Yeah, stop being so friggin' nosy.
I don't know, Bree. It's not that bad. I know I've got more than a few moments in my life that I'd like to forget about altogether.
My childhood or my parents, but I've been able to move on with my life.
Don't take this the wrong way, but that's just so weird. From what you're telling us, it sounds like there's a huge stretch of your life that you can't account for.
Yeah, my life is like that too.
How could she possibly take that the wrong way, Gabby?
I'd like to take this time to apologize on Gabrielle's behalf. Apparently she's been taking notes from the Edie Britt School of Social
All I'm saying is that when you only know about one half of your life, there's no telling when the other half might come back for a visit.
Ladies, what do you say we cut the small talk and get down to business?
Where's the human sacrifice?
I don't want our new neighbor to think I'm a snoop or anything, but I saw Edie do something questionable the other day.
But what?
You won't think any less of me for divulging this bit of gossip, will you?
I couldn't care less. Couldn't think less of you. That one.
I saw her sneaking around and digging through people's mailboxes while I was out jogging.
My mailbox?
No, it wasn't any of ours. But I thought you should all know about it.
What are you talking about?
These pills.
Pills? So that's what you was looking for. I wonder what they are. They're probably special.